I'm Chris Smiley with If Americans Knew. Israel is notorious for attacking journalists and trying to suppress the truth. I've personally been attacked and have also witnessed other journalists being attacked for trying to cover the crimes of the state.
And straight at me! Attack.
Why is it at us? We are journalists. Why is it at us?
Their methods for suppression of the press range from physical assault to imprisonment and straight up murder, as we've extensively covered here on If Americans Knew. Please click on the links in the description to find out more. There is currently a bill in the Israeli parliament waiting to be passed that would officially make it illegal for journalists to record or photograph Israeli soldiers. Now, I say officially because it's already common practice for Israel to arrest journalists who are simply doing their job. Ali Dar Ali, a well-known reporter for Palestine TV, was arrested this week under the charge of incitement for his filming of Israeli forces in the illegally occupied West Bank. This charge of incitement is commonly used against Palestinian journalists to arrest and silence them. Ali, like many journalists, are arrested for simply reporting and documenting events. They do not incite or advocate anything illegal. But I guess Israel thinks that folks might get just a little bit angry if they see their crimes against humanity, so they gotta cover it up. Earlier this month, dozens of Palestinian journalists took part in a protest outside Ofer military prison near Ramallah to demand the release of 21 Palestinian journalists doing time. When those journalists get out, though, they might not have a job to return to. As the Israeli military shuts down Palestinian media outlets regularly, they closed a total of 17 just last year and continue to do so.
Internal Security Agency searched and raided different media outlets in Judea and Samaria that are suspect of inciting terrorism, violence, and promoting violence against Israeli civilians.
Israel is following a systematic policy in dealing with Palestinian journalists. This is happening whether through destroying media outlets, such as what happened to the Sanabel radio station in Al-Khalil, or through direct physical assaults. The aim is to keep the journalist from his or her work and preventing a true witness to the crimes Israel commits.
A couple of months ago, Israel even closed down a youth media center, which helps kids explore media production and produce local stories. Israel called the children terrorists. The nonprofit Committee for the Protection of Journalists denounced this action, saying, quote, "Israeli Defense Minister Lieberman has failed to produce any evidence that the Aliyah Youth Media Foundation is a terrorist organization. It is absurd to equate young reporters with terrorists. We call on the Israeli authorities to allow Aliyah Youth Media to resume its work and to stop harassing the press." Thank you for watching. Please share this video and stay tuned to If Americans Knew for the latest news and analysis.